Hey gang, my name is Tanner, and I have an autoimmune disease called vitiligo, which causes my skin to depigment in patches. You may be asking yourself, hey, isn't that the disease that Michael Jackson had? You're right, which explains where I got all my stellar dance moves. Growing up, I had no idea what vitiligo was. I just knew that there was a part of me that was whiter, and part of me that was Tanner. I didn't think much about vitiligo until I got to elementary school. I remember sitting in an assembly with some kids, sitting there cross-legged in the gym, and the kid next to me recoiled in fear when he saw the discoloration on my knees. He was so scared of catching whatever it was that I had. I think he said it was skin worms. Ah, the birth of a psychological complex. I didn't know what to say because I had no idea what it actually was. My best guess was that it was leprosy because I read in the Bible that leprosy makes your skin turn white. Rather than suffering the embarrassment of not knowing what to say, I just started making stuff up. Kids would say, hey, why do your elbows look so weird? And I'd say, you know the things the cows have? I have that. Call me cowboy. Though I tried to be humorous about it, I was actually deeply insecure. Not only did I have white patches of skin, I was also very small, which made me an easy target for bullies. As a result, I spent several years feeling very, very lonely. One day a woman stopped me in a public library. She was dressed in black, had this nose ring, which I assumed meant she was a bad person, but she stopped me and she said, I see you have vitiligo. And then she asked, do the kids make fun of you for it? I didn't really know what to say, so I said, sometimes. And she said, never, ever let them make fun of you for it. You are awesome the way you are. And then she walked away, I walked away, and I never saw her again. But that was a surprise to me. I'd never heard the word vitiligo. I'd never seen anybody else with it. So I went home, got on the computer, dialed up the internet, which is a very old sentence, and I couldn't remember the word vitiligo, so I just typed in white patches of skin, and that's when I found the information about what vitiligo was. One of the things I learned about it is that it's triggered by psychological distress, which for a psychologically distressed kid was, to say the least, psychologically distressing. I was just getting to the age where I wanted girls to be attracted to me. Like I said, I was small, I was feeling ugly, and now I had to worry that my worry would make me even more ugly. To make matters worse, I could see the white spots beginning to spread on my forehead, my eyelids, my lips, my hands. It seemed like a nightmare. I remember one time being on the beach with some friends. I was laying there, they assumed I was asleep, and I could hear them talking about me. Apparently the sun had burned my eyelids, making them bright pink. And I remember hearing one of my friends say, oh, he looks like a panda. Maybe an inverted panda. I just lied there pretending to be asleep. When they finally left, I just cried and cried and cried because I just felt so ugly. And I just wallowed like that for the rest of the trip. On the way home from California back to Arizona, I was sitting in the car thinking about how I was feeling. And I thought to myself, self, you can either spend your whole life wallowing in self-pity, feeling ugly, or you can focus on cultivating inward beauty. And so that's what I decided to do. I said, I'm not going to worry about this anymore. I'm just going to try to be the best person that I can be, regardless of how I look. That was over 10 years ago, and it's something I've been working on all this time. And to tell you the truth, sometimes it's a struggle. There was a long time when I was afraid to go out into the sun for fear of, you know, making the condition worse. When I became sexually active, I was mortified at what people would think of the white patches on my hips, my legs, my genitals, just terrified. But ultimately, I kept going back to the resolution I made as a 16-year-old. I wasn't going to let fear keep me from living my best life. As I've stepped into the sun, literally and metaphorically, I've learned a couple things. Number one, I don't worry about what other people think because chances are they aren't thinking of me at all. Turns out most people are too hung up on their own securities to give a shit about mine. Which brings me to point number two. Everybody is insecure about something. Even some of the most attractive, fit, healthy people you can imagine struggle with self-worth. It's just part of being human. Everybody struggles with something, so there's no point of me sitting there feeling like I'm this lone sufferer while everybody else has their shit together. That's just not how it is. Three, True beauty is based on self-acceptance. Nobody can tell you that you are worthy. Nobody can tell you that you are beautiful. That's something that has to come from within you. Fear is paralyzing. Self-acceptance is empowering. Accept yourself in all your glorious imperfection, and you'll see your life begin to flourish and increase in beauty. 4. Self-acceptance is contagious. As the matron saint of my heart, Brené Brown, once said, when you get to a place where you understand that love and belonging, your worthiness, is a birthright and not something you have to earn, anything is possible. When you stand in the power of your individual worthiness, you give other people permission to do the same, and that is beautiful. People who view their uniquenesses as opportunities rather than limitations literally change the world. It's been a long time coming, but now I can finally say that I am not ashamed of my body. In fact, I feel proud of it. My skin makes me unique. I feel like a happy hippie with tie-dye skin. I'm not afraid of being seen. I'm not afraid of being vulnerable. I'm not afraid of being me. Your body is an incredible gift that is billions and billions of years in the making. Untold organisms have lived, suffered, reproduced, and died to create the genetic code that has culminated in you, the vessel through which the universe is finally experiencing consciousness. Your body is the gift that the world has given itself. So live through it fully, without fear, and you'll find that the world will repay the favor. Love yourself, spots and all, and watch the magic happen. Peace and love.